about to take you step by step through this painting. This painting took about an hour, and hopefully not only you learn something, it might stimulate your creativity to not copy it, but do your own little twist on it, or maybe learn a couple techniques you apply to your art. Let's do some painting. I was asked to kind of go through my creative process here, and I was given a challenge. The challenge was to grab four different products from the Tommy Art DIY system and create a painting, just kind of thinking about how I can use them, mix and match them. How creative can I be with just four items? So the items they gave me were the bronze metallic, and they gave me the English blue mineral paint, and they gave me the sand paste and some antique wax. Now, that was the big throw out at me because I've never used antique wax before, but I've kind of been playing around with it and I have some ideas. And the first thing I did when I got some new items is I started looking at certain things, such as I started looking at what kind of different values can I get, or what kind of different looks can I get from the same materials. So put together different swatches of different values and different things that I can do with the same products. And this is just the start of my imagination of where I can go and the different type of things I can get with it. So this is enough to kind of get my brain cooking. So let's do some stuff. So I first of all drew out a very simple pencil drawing of angel wing. We'll just start with that. And I'm gonna see what I can kind of go with this. So what I would suggest is you could either take the paper and tear it to give it a nice worn look, or I just took some black gesso and I just kind of made a kind of a black border around it. I know that wasn't one of my products, but just to start out with, if you started out, I just kind of tear the edges. For me personally, I just don't like things to look, you know, perfectly straight and neat and perfect. That's just kind of my thing. So let's figure out what I'm gonna start out with. First thing I'm gonna do is I think I'm gonna give it kind of a weathered look. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a little bit. I took some of that wax and I mixed it with some of that bronze. The way I did it is I melted the wax. Don't melt that wax in a microwave. There's a mineral kind of a base to it, and it doesn't work well with microwaves. So I just put this into some hot water. Let's put the jar into some hot water. And then that tends to mix real nice with that bronze. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kind of just put a little bit of that, just the bronzy part. And that gives me kind of a really no wrong way to do this. I'm just kind of going for, I'm going to start off with that. Then I'm going to come in with regular antique wax. And I'm just going to kind of just give it kind of a weathered look. Pull some of that bronze over. Give it an old look. Weather it up a little bit. Now, this is just kind of a first little layer. It's kind of weathered the paper just a tad. Now I'm going to put a light layer of the sand paste. Now the sand paste is going to give it a little bit of texture, but I think I'm just going to start by just starting off, put a little sandy texture on there. And just a light layer. And don't be afraid to go ahead and just be messy. We're going to come back in here and we're going to get the palette knife and we're going to really start putting some nice little textures in there. I think I just want to get a little bit of a sandy texture. I'll be coming in here and doing more of this. I think I also want to get a little sandy texture in that background, because I'm going to come over this and I want to give a nice separation. So I'm gonna start building some layers into that background. So I'm gonna start putting a little texture on there. One thing I really didn't get into until I started playing around with the DIY system is that I wasn't really understanding of texture and how much life they can give a piece. More than just my traditional illustrated painting. I got hooked real fast, tell you what. And I love the fact that actually all of those different products are very simply in the same line. And that eliminated that confusion for me, and it actually stimulated me to go ahead and try some stuff that I never would have thought of trying before. And it's expanding my art pretty extensively, just having that creative avenue and a way to kind of eliminate that confusion and eliminate that thought process of I am looking for a paint. Instead, I'm looking for a creative avenue to create my art. Okay, I got me a little texture on there. This is gonna dry pretty fast. Let me just pop that layer on there. I'm gonna start now adding some layers of blues here. And I'm still gonna keep it kind of somewhat of a wide brush because I'm doing some pretty broad strokes here. I'll come into detail, but I'm gonna build layers of texture because when I put some antiquing wax in here, I want to start getting into some of these crevices and giving me a very antique but also vibrant look. So I'm gonna take a little bit of that English blue, just a little bit, because I'm gonna start off going light to dark. So I took a little bit of this sand paste and I put it in a separate container. I'm gonna start off with, and I'm gonna start just building up the blues while I build up the textures. So I'll go for a light blue to begin with. And I think I'll start right here and I'll start building up light blue on those feathers. So I'll show you an example. I build up some of that. I go ahead and I put this sand paste in a separate container. I don't want to be mixing colors. I'll keep my other sand paste pretty darn white. That saves me a little bit of a mess. So let me see here. So just kind of build up. Notice again, I'm not trying to brush it on like I'm doing. And I'm going for some pretty broad strokes here. Just building up layers and layers of that texture. Again, as this dries, I'll have some nice thick layers of texture. Oh yeah. Now look, really looking to deposit a lot. Again, not really even thinking detail just yet. Just building layers on those feathers. What I also suggest is keeping a black and white copy of the illustration. So when you start covering up some of the actual initial black and white drawing I did, you can still have that as somewhat of a reference kind of paint from. Now, as I start building these layers and as I start painting, I guess one of the frustrations when being asked to take my creativity and break it down step by step, so I can teach others to think like me and not create and be creative on their own. That was kind of a little stopping point for me, but then I got to thinking, by me just showing my creative process, maybe I can help show you how to kind of think yourself out of situations, think differently, evolve your thinking, think creatively. And also, here's what I hope. I hope that you will try to work within this system and start thinking of your own creative techniques and your own ways to overcome some challenges that you'll be having. So I laid around a nice layer of light blue. I threw some texture on that. Perfect. One thing I do to speed up the process is I'll take my heat gun and I'll put it on low heat, and then it takes me about 30 seconds in between steps as opposed to waiting, you know, five or so minutes in between steps. Doesn't seem like much time, but I think when you're in kind of a creative groove, especially when you're doing the big strokes, it saves energy, you know? Keeps that creative energy going. All right, let's go to the next step of blue. Added just a little bit more blue. And again, though this is not gonna be the final blue along here, I'm still gonna put it on here because it's gonna add those layers I'm talking about. And that's really the biggest thing, is I'm adding layers, eventually covering up the below illustration completely. So again, if you kind of want to draw yourself, or you understand wings, or you want to kind of do this your own creative way, just kind of cover up the painting and start, or cover up the drawing and then start painting. However, nothing wrong with having this initial illustration sitting on the side. If you have it sitting on the side though, try not to look at it too much. And the reason I say that is I want, as soon as you possibly can, to put your own thoughts into this piece. I want your own, how do I say to my students, flavor coming in. I want you being creative. I want you to be a creator, not a copyist. And initially it's fine mimicking, it's fine trying out different techniques, it's great learning new techniques. However, I want as soon as possible for you to be trying your own thoughts and your own techniques. Start putting them layers in. I cannot stress enough to actually not worry about doing any detail. We're just doing gradations of blue right now, is really it. And go ahead and feel free to be as rambunctious as you darn well please. Right now, by the way, nothing wrong with having the soundtrack of Rent going on behind you. When put in a bunch of gradations here. Now, here's where the fun part. The paint is still wet. I really don't want this to dry right now, because what I want you to start to be thinking is I want you to be thinking about sculpting into the paint. I want you to sculpt feather shapes into this paint. Not really drawing, see, not really doing that, but just see if you can sculpt some, not only shapes, so let me get that feather. Looking for, gosh, a big payoff at the end. Like prepping to see what comes through, what doesn't. I'm gonna take just this copper and I'm gonna just put that into some of the deeper crevices. And let's see if we can get that to come out a little bit. Final step before I do the antiquing wax. I'm gonna come back in a little bit darker blue. I'm gonna dry brush a little bit of a darker blue back into the white. Just a little bit. Now, I'm usually a fan of the antiquing coating. However, we didn't have any of that in the factory. So, they said you gotta make it with antique wax. And what I like about that is it forced me to learn something new, try things new, do different combinations. And I think I'm finding very unconventional ways to utilize this wax. My suggestion is, when going melting your antiquing wax, is use just water. And I just found when it goes in the microwave that there's something weird. I mean, no matter what container I use, there's some weird sparks that happen. Yeah, that's good. Much better. Able to actually direct it a little bit better. I want to kind of do this here, kind of show you just one technique. And then I'll get in there. If I do a couple different layers, I can actually get a darker look. I'm going to do kind of a weird little outline. All right, antiquing brought it all out. Oh, it's so cool. I'm going to go through a few final things. I'm going to start adding some of this copper. I'm going to come back in. with that English blue. And I'm just going to kind of bring a lid, just a little vibrancy back. Just a little bit. Come back in with a little bit of that sand paste, and I'm going to just put a little bit of white back in there. All right, final appearance for this antiquing wax and bronze. I'm sorry, copper. See, when the antiquing wax and the copper comes together, it makes it look very, very bronze. I like the white on this because the white separates that hair from the shoulder, so I want to keep that. Okay, I'm going to grab just a little more sand paste, and I'm just going to put just a little more texture. This might work, it might not, but I think it's worth the shot. You can't be worried if you're going to screw something up. Cool thing is, you can always go back. I want to see if I can get some of this beautiful copper in some of these crevices. So I'm just going to do this. I watered it down just a little bit. I don't want to do it on everything. Oh, if this works, I think it's going to look super cool. Now, after I do that, I'm going to dab some of that excess off of there. But leave that shine in the cracks. Then I think I'll dry brush a little bit more color, but leave that shine in there. I like that. Oh, I think that's gonna look super cool. I finally took a little extra bronze and I highlighted some of the feathers. I think that really looks wonderful.